Yellow duckies, and welcome back to Green's Wish 2. My name's Viola. If you like what you see, hit the like button and subscribe if you haven't already. It really does help the channel. It seems there is need of us to assist in a situation. This is the audience hall. Princess Viola, we are honored to have you. We are honored that you have arrived. We are facing a very difficult decision right now. It is important enough in this troubled time that the wisdom of royalty would be invaluable. She nods towards the silent, proud Roe warrior. This is Dastan, a warrior of the Gentle Coast. He is on trial. Hello, Dastan. Dastan stares straight ahead, ignoring you. It looks like he has been punched repeatedly in the face recently. What is Dastan's crime? As Chief Setas speaks, you note that the Havenite guards are scowling at Dastan. Lots of hatred in the room right now. Drunken brawl with tragic results. Dastan was in an alley fight with one of Haven's soldiers. Scout Chance was the name. Chance was killed. Dastan stumbled out of the alley with a bloody blade and was apprehended. He slew one of Haven's soldiers. He did. The Havenites nod angrily. Of course, when a vassal kills a Havenite, it is a truly serious matter. There is no question of guilt. Now a punishment must be given. What do we know about this crime? No surprises, really. A crowded bar in Lascara. Lots of drinking, angry words were exchanged, no doubt inflamed by the recent raids, and an attempt on your life. Someone suggested that the two warriors duel in the alley outside. The duel took place. Dastan won. What do you have to say for yourself? Dastan. Dastan turns and looks you dead in the eye. I thought we would fight with hands, a matter of honor. Your chance was losing. He drew his sword and came at me, the coward. I drew my sword and cut him down. I defended myself, as is my right. And Scout Chance was from Hades. Giuseppe says he was not Havenborn. He was from Archimen, the next country to the west. A sworn soldier of the Haven's army, with a decent record. And what do you expect me to do? Tell us what must be done with Dastan. It is delicate. If he is spared, Haven will look weak and Havenites will be angry at you. If you punish him, Thoreau will see this as an injustice. Unpleasant. Thus, I refer to you. We have no reason to question the facts of the case. Self-defense, but a vassal killed a sworn soldier of Haven. Any advice, Sidis? She clears her throat nervously. If I knew the best judgment, I would have given it already. The scowls of the soldiers of Haven in attendance leave no doubt what they will do. Are we sure it was self-defense? Two walked into the alley, one walked out. We can never know what the truth of the story is. I'm sure that Dastan's deep truth is that he was in the right. Dastan doesn't respond. And if I choose not to decide, then I will have to sentence Dastan to death. I am a soldier of Haven, I must look after our interests. I've made my decision. Flog Dastan, then send him home. No, I don't. If I don't punish him in some way, Haven Knights will get angry. Chief Setas nods, so declared. Princess. I sentence Destin to public flogging. Get him out of here. Soldiers look away from you, failing to conceal their anger. Destin walks out of the hall with head held high. The gentle coast will be annoyed. Ro will be angry. But they are always angry. Seems like whatever I choose, someone will be angry at me. Of course. That's just the way of the Rokash. Anger and grudges. Heaped on more anger and grudges. If a decision will make someone angry, then it becomes a diplomatic matter. Then, if I can, I refer to you. I'll be going now. We'll be happy to help with future cases. Thetis nods happily. Of course. You're very kind. When you visit General Miranda, I will be here, cleaning up mess after mess. Thank you. All the messes. General Miranda. Let's see. I think I already... Yeah. That needs attending to? Anyone else that needs attending to? Port. Want to go home. Can I go to the port? Can I go to the portal? I want to go home. Home, home, home. Hello, Stonehouse. Any messages for me? I go downstairs to check the mirror frequently. It's currently silent. I saw them. Here. I have hunted these books. I'm so glad you remembered my humble request. What did you find? I don't have anything yet. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay. Alright. Can I put a distillery in the guard tower? I mean, that would be nice. Ooh, looks like I do have the space for that. There's a neglected guard tower in the corner of the fortress. Normally you would expect to see ballistas and watchful guards upstairs. These days, who knows what mess you'll find. The lower level is dusty and empty. Floor is scratched and worn. Whatever work was done here, the equipment was removed some time ago. You will need to find a use for this open space. Nice to know. And I've already upgraded it, so we've got the actual tower still, which is nice. Okay. See flickering lights. They hover over the marshy ground 50 feet away. Then they flit off into the mist. A lesser explorer might be lured into quicksand by such a phenomenon. You know better. Maybe I will follow it. Maybe I won't. Maybe I'll come out and come over here and figure out what's over here. Huge nest of sticks and trash out here in the depths of the swamp. Gnawed bones are everywhere. There are tracks in the muck, but they are old and indistinct. Nothing of interest. Okay. Darn. Ghosty! The mist grows icy cold. Frost crunches under your feet. A shade floats through the mist towards you. As you shiver, it drifts to a halt in front of you, watching you, judging you. You are immediately reminded of the shade that spoke to you back at the lighthouse. The Rokash is a land tormented by ghosts. Often literally. After a tense, silent pause, the shade turns and floats off to the north. You're soon lost in the fog. Okay then. Foggy ghost? Ghosty fog? You hear whispering. It comes from all around you. It sends shivers up and down your spine, making you want to flee into the marsh in terror, but you keep control. The feeling fades. We're going to save here real quick because I already know what's coming. We've been through this once before. It did not go nicely. Oh boy! Oh god! Why? Why did I just get startled by a rat? Oh boy! There's a lot of rats. Lots of rats! No, no, not what I wanted to do. There's a lot of rats! A lot of rats! Rats! Oh my gosh, so much poison. So much. Her before she dies. Okay. Now there are more rats this way. Okay. So we cleared out some rats. And this is another entry down below. Oh gosh, whoa, where did they come from? I didn't even see them there. I keep getting startled by just about everything. Because everything wants to startle me, apparently. You guys hear little squeaky noises behind me. That would be little squeaky Gloria, who is being a little squeaky baby. Because it's coming up to her dinner time when I'm recording this. And she is like, I want food. I'm also getting tail whipped because of it. I don't know if what I'm doing deserves tail whipping, Gloria. In fact, I'm pretty sure I don't deserve any of that. They're like sneaky. They're sneaky sneaky. Thank you. there's so many skeletons down here. I just know. Oh, yeah. What are you going to do with the cave creature? Hear what they have to say. Once I have listened, I will make them return to their rest. Angry shades are a problem. Why is it a problem? Okay, we've been through all of this. Okay, I think I need to... shades before just wiped us out. Absolutely wiped us out. So we're gonna take a little bit of a different tactic here. If we can help it. Okay. All right. Wiped out the first section. Let's save again. I'm being cautious this time because I know what happened last time. Let's wait until they actually catch up with us, and then we will go down. Let's go over to this room. Door's icy cold, hurts to touch. Give it a good shove, but the door refuses to budge. Okay, but we want to stick together. Okay. When Miss Talker Vanessa gets close to the ghost, it turns to face her. It solidifies into a form of a rogue warrior long dead. It ignores you. Vanessa says, "Ghost, this is not your land and not your place. You must return to the earth until you are called forth." Let's just listen. Ghost says, "I am Kal. I say Haven has returned. It walks free. Kal died to fight Haven. We all died in the Great Uprising. You never avenged us. You failed us. So we must act." Listen more. This says, "This is a time of change. Haven will be made to answer for its deeds. However, you will not be involved. You must rest. This is not your place or time." The Shade says, "We have been trapped in this land of cowards and weaklings for 100 years, watching our homeland rot. And you want us to rest? Return to the earth? No, we will rise at last." Let's just prepare for battle. You draw your weapon, so does Vanessa. The Shade throws its arms wide, and ghosts rise up through the earth all around you. As they appear, a faint shield appears around Ka. Okay. So... left. Mm. so many of them. What we can do is just work on it. In our own time. Don't have any. Vanessa. It's just going to keep evading until we get rid of the shades, I have a feeling. So we shouldn't be focusing on this. We should be focusing the rest of the shades. Oh gosh. But he's the problem. Come on. Vanessa, you aren't helping. Not up to this one yet. Gosh. Can we even go into this bigger building? No. Do we have to play our way all the way back in? Yeah, we do. Actually, you know what? Let's load from our save. Okay. Okay, so let's I doubt if I say anything different, it'll do anything different, but let's actually try to talk to it. I am Viola, Princess of the Sea. Ghost turns towards you and lets out a hiss. Haven, you are a tormentor. We will not speak with you. But as perhaps I should be the one who speaks. Listen. Perhaps I can negotiate with you. The room goes icy cold. Chill saying that didn't help. Listen more. We don't need to fight. Actually, I think we do. Okay. We need to focus the shades. Focus the shades, focus the shades, focus the... Oh my gosh. Instantly. And Vanessa's gone. Okay, he's really... Okay, nope, nope, nope. Don't speak. Got it. Don't speak. Don't speak. Makes him angry. Just listen. Oh, she's over there. Okay. It's gonna go down. Yep, there goes. Nope, he's immune to fear. Okay. Aha, we can stun him. That. And then... this is taking a lot of damage. We can get to the shade. There we go. The ghost of Cal is cleaved in two by a final blow, letting out a furious hiss. It sinks down through the stone, leaving only a trace of frost behind. The workshop has been freed from its possession. Miss Talker, Vanessa looks around the workshop for a while, looking for other signs of hauntings. Finally satisfied, she says it is done. This place is clean now, but there are crimes that must be answered for. shades have been defeated. Yes. They have returned to the earth. Haven killed them in the Great Uprising. They sensed you were near. They came out for revenge. Should not be allowed. Your time has passed. What now? Now the workers can return to work. Perhaps Tahomer will reward you. I will report to the Hyalitha. This is a dangerous situation. Much is out of balance. Then, without a word of thanks or farewell, she turns and leaves the hall. Manners and social graces are apparently not huge in the Hyalitha. Not worth it. We'll sell it. Yep. Okay, there we go. Purged your workshop of trees. Yes, we felt the change. We are grateful. We have the Hyalitha cold. We are not selfish or thoughtless. Perhaps I could get a reward? Tilmir nods. This is fair. However, I am an alchemist, not a trader. Our negotiations are done by Ajea and Lascara. Okay. Yep. Okay. Gotcha, gotcha. Roger, roger. I will go and talk to someone in Lascara. Momentarily popping into my base because everybody needed healing and potions restored and all that sort of good. This is just, that's the Haven Hall. I think it was the Trading Hall, maybe? Oh wait, no. It was in the inn. I know where she is. I've purged the Lissa claim of books. Tell the story to Ajaya. She listens, stony-faced, while sipping her drink. Then she nods. Good. I thank you. I will make sure that supplies are sent to your forts. I think you will find the payment adequate. You wait for her to elaborate. In vain. Okay. Well, I mean, that's good. And I needed it to upgrade my fort, so it's completely safe now. You can now dedicate this fort to a sort of production. It can focus on knowledge, military production, or diplomacy. Each can be improved up to 4 times and give you a different bonus. Knowledge. Concentrate on gathering magical knowledge and equipment. Your reserves of power will be deeper. So the level gives a 5% chance to retain used energy. Industry. Concentrate on workshops, helping them provide more and better equipment, or row. working with and helping the local Rokash, bringing them a share of Hagen's prosperity. Each level improves your reputation with the Rokash, making them more likely to help you. Provides a 2% discount to all prices in shops. Yeah. Okay. So that's going to be it for today's episode. So thank you all for watching. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to ring the bell icon to keep up to date on all the written videos. And remember to free the feral wildflower in you. Bye-bye.